Welcome back to Proactive London, where I'm talking to Sean Heathcote now. He is the CEO of Neo Energy Metals. And Sean, it is great to have you on the line. How are you?
Fantastic. Thanks very much, Thomas. And thanks for inviting me.
It's absolutely fantastic, obviously, Sean. And it is, I believe, the only primarily uranium exploration company on the main board. So tell us a bit, firstly, about why uranium?
Thanks, Thomas. Yes, and it is the only pure exploration play on the main board. There is a producer and an ETF in terms of yellow cake that's already on the board, but with a pure exploration play. And obviously, it's the strongest uranium market that I've seen in 30 years. Spot prices on the rise. There's a tightness in the market going forward. There's a huge demand for nuclear going forward in terms of both new reactors, main scale reactors, and small modular reactors. So we see an incredibly bright future for Neo over the course of the next 5 to 8 years.
So let's hear a little bit more about the investment proposition. It is quite a simple one, of course, obviously. It is one project, one commodity. So get us up to speed with the project, if you would, Sean.
Yeah, the project is the Henkries Project in just outside Springbok in South Africa. It's a very, very shallow deposit. There's about 4.7 million pounds in the ground of uranium at present. Sounds small, but obviously because it is so close to the surface and it's so easy to mine and so easy to process, on the back of an Anglo-American study that was done quite a few years back, and it's been proven over 6 months of pilot plant testing and trial mining, test pits, etc. So we know it's very easy to process and very easy to get into production quickly. So in essence, what we're doing is updating that feasibility study and trying to get into production as fast as possible with a very a small operation that we look to expand.
I'm going to ask you about the next steps momentarily, but I do just want to zoom in a little bit on that project, because everybody knows that South Africa is obviously very commodity rich and has a very good history with extraction and production and exploration, all these things. But it does have the challenge of intermittent energy supplies. So that is going to be a key consideration for you guys, isn't it?
Absolutely. And yet it's something that we have thought about long and hard and tried to make the mine as sustainable and as circular as we possibly can. So one of the key things that we'll be looking at is putting in some sort of renewable generation capacity at site, be it wind and solar. Obviously, it's in a desert arid region, so there's plenty of sun. It gets quite hot there in the summer. And we're only about 2 kilometers away from the Orange River, which is the largest river in South Africa, 11 billion cubic meters a year of water going down. So we can look at hydropower generation as well. So yes, power generation is going to be on the agenda for us. But there is Eskom running through the property as it stands at the minute. So, and it's a reliable supply. There's a large substation there. So for construction purposes and for backup purposes, obviously Eskom will be of great support to us.
Absolutely. So let's turn to those next steps now, Sean. The listing is now done. The hard work really begins. So what's the biggest thing in your in-tray at the moment, do you think?
It's really increasing the size of the deposit. That's what we're going to be focusing on. I mean, we've got some samples at surface that have not been analyzed. We're going to get those analyzed and put that into resource model. We expect 1.1 to 2 million pounds to come from those samples at surface. Get the drilling program. We're going to do about another 6,500 meters worth of drilling to go with the 18,000 meters that's already been drilled to increase the size of the deposit. We're going to target 10 million pounds worth of uranium in the ground. That gets us a nice size project to move forward and get into production quickly.
Let me wish you the very best of luck with it, Sean. Thank you very much for taking the time to talk to us on such a big day for the company.
And thanks very much for your input, Thomas. Thank you.